This is a tutorial on how to view quantitative values in Scaffold. Once you have sorted the data based on the student's t-test p-values of less than 0.05, select the Displays option drop-down menu. Choose Quantitative Value Normalized Total Spectra. Scroll to the far right of the screen. You should now be able to see measured values for each protein in all cell cultures. Highlighted in the purple columns are the data from the Jurkat leukemia cell lines, which were treated with the anti-heat shock protein 90 drug AUI922. Highlighted in the beige column are data from the Jurkat leukemia cells, which has served as the controls for this experiment. These cells did not receive the AUI922 drug. What you will do is compare a selected protein whose expression is statistically changed with treatment with AUI922. Note that there are three columns for each, the treated cells and the control cells. This tells us that the experiment had replicates. To interpret the data, evaluate the numbers of the treated versus control cells. The control cells receive no drug, so they will be our normal in this interpretation. I'll select a protein that is not statistically different to show you an example. I have chosen phosphatidylethanolamine binding protein 1. It doesn't pass our student's t-test value criteria of having a p-value of less than 0.051. Therefore, this is simply an example as how to interpret the data. Comparing the treated versus control data, I can see that the treated cells have values of 5, 4, and 10, while the untreated cells have levels of 16, 16, and 10. If the control cells are normal, then I can interpret that 5, 4, and 10 are less than 16, 16, and 10. This tells me that the protein, phosphatidylethanolamine binding protein 1, expression levels are likely lowered in the AUI922 treated cells when compared to the control cells. Conversely, if I look at heterogeneous nuclear ribonucleoprotein R data, it appears that this protein is expressed in greater amounts with values of 15, 17, and 16 in the treated cells when compared to the control cells with values of 15, 11, and 12. For those data sets that have a zero or a gray box shown, that does not mean that the protein was absent. Consider that a baseline. Those proteins are expressed. Conduct this type of analysis for your chosen protein. Remember to choose a protein whose expression is statistically significant with a student's t-test p-value of less than or equal to 0.05.